three major facial features affected by facial aging: loss of skeletal contour of the lower face, loss of volume, and loss of skin uniformity. When the operating surgeon performs a facelift, zones of adherence of the superficial musculoponeurotic system, SMAS, are encountered that alternate with zones where mobilization proceeds with relative ease. These zones of adherence are in relationship to the retaining ligaments of the face. Facial aging is a multifactorial process involving the skin, soft tissues, and facial skeleton. As the face ages, there are predictable surface, volume, and positional changes. Laxity of the ligaments and fat compartment deflation create visible surface depressions and creases seen with aging. Described by Furness in 1989, retaining ligaments are fibrous structures in predictable locations of the face connecting bone to the overlying facial skin, crossing all layers of soft tissue. Retaining ligaments are landmarks for facial rejuvenation procedures as they separate facial fat compartment. They are intimately related to the branches of the facial nerve, and are structural components of facial support and aged appearance. Facial retaining ligaments. These consistent retaining ligaments have been inconsistently named by different investigators due to subjective interpretation. As a result, ligaments were discovered and named, then rediscovered and renamed, which has led to some confusion. Definitions. The retaining ligaments of the face are strong and deep fibrous attachments that originate from the periosteum or deep facial fascia and travel perpendicularly through facial layers to insert onto the dermis. The retaining ligaments of the face are dense fibrous adhesions between the periosteum or deeper fixed structures and the dermis. Once reaching the SMAS and dermal layer, the facial structure divides and forms a complex network of fibrous septa in the subcutaneous tissue called the retinacular cutis. The combination of the retinacular cutis and retaining ligaments form the superficial and deep fat compartments of the face. Microscopically, each ligament is rooted in a tree-like distribution as a periosteal or deep facial thickening that divides as it approaches the SMAS into numerous branches, which insert onto the dermis as described by Mendelssohn. These ligaments act as anchor points, retaining and stabilizing the skin and superficial fascia to the underlying deep fascia and facial skeleton in defined anatomic location. Anatomic pearls. Clear description of the ligamentous anatomy in the superficial tissues of the head and neck has required the introduction of a number of new terms. The ligaments have been classified according to three morphological forms: true ligaments, septa, and adhesions. True ligament. A true ligament is a discrete cylindrical arrangement of fibrous tissue that is surrounded by fatty tissue. True ligaments were found in the medial midface and lower face and provided the greatest latitude of movement of all the attachments. True ligaments arise from either the deep fascia or the periosteum, then cross the sub-SMAS plane to the undersurface of the SMAS, where they divide into numerous branches in a tree-like fashion. These branches then distribute the attachment of the ligament to the dermis through a subcutaneous facial system, the retinacula cutis. Examples include the zygomatic and masseteric ligaments. Septum. A septum is a fibrous wall passing between the deep fascia and the undersurface of the SMAS. This arrangement permits mobility only in a plane perpendicular to the deep line of attachment of the septum. Most of the septa defined within the head and neck are located in the temporal and periorbital regions. Examples include the inferior temporal septum, the superior temporal septum, and the periorbital septum. Adhesion. Adhesion is a low-density area of fibrous or fibrofatty adhesion between the deep fascia/pericranium and the superficial fascia. Basically a two-dimensional structure, an adhesion restricts mobility in all directions and to the greatest degree of the three forms. It is important to note that septa and adhesions retain the SMAS plane only, and considerable mobility may still occur at more superficial layers. Aside from the preauricular and parotid regions, adhesions were found only in the forehead and temporal regions. Examples include the temporal and the supraorbital ligamentous adhesions. No true ligaments were seen in these regions. Classification. Stuzan et al. Classified the retaining ligaments as 1. Osteocutaneous ligaments originating from the periosteum, such as the zygomatic and mandibular cutaneous ligaments, and 2. Fasciocutaneous ligaments, which coalesce between the superficial and deep fasciae of the face, as with the masseteric and parotid cutaneous ligaments. Nyes and Moss et al. Nyes and Moss et al. Considered a true retaining ligament to be a cylindrical arrangement of fibrous tissue that meets the above-mentioned microscopic criteria and inserts directly into the dermis. Examples of true retaining ligaments, per this definition, are the zygomatic and masseteric retaining ligaments. Moss et al. Described other forms of ligamentous attachments, mainly in the temporal and periorbital area, in the form of septa and adhesions. According to Nyes and Moss, septa and adhesions are not considered true retaining ligaments since they do not insert directly onto the dermis. Instead, the septa exert a direct effect on the SMAS and an indirect effect on the dermis through the retinacular cutis. The orbitomalar ligament, also known as the orbicularis retaining ligament, is morphologically a septal structure, but it should be considered a true ligament according to the Moss et al. Classification since it does attach directly to the dermis. The zygomatic cutaneous ligaments located posteriorly along the zygomatic arch take a septal form, while the anterior ones over the junction of the arch and body of the zygoma take a more cylindrical form. Mendelssohn et al. Indicated that the retinacular cutis could not be seen in the area of the zygomatic cutaneous ligaments medial to the zygomaticus major muscle, which means that direct dermal attachment was not histologically proven. However, the zygomatic cutaneous ligaments are considered true retaining ligaments. Finally, the lateral temporal cheek fat compartment described by Rorick and Pessa has both the superior and inferior temporal septa as its boundaries, which means that both of these septa should have a superficial extension connecting the superficial temporal fascia to the dermis, i.e. they should connect directly to the dermis. Retaining ligaments of the temporal area. Nyes described a zone of adhesion, also called the zone of fixation, as a 6 mm wide zone located immediately medial to the superior temporal fusion line where the galea and the periosteum are fixed to bone. At the distal end of the zone of adhesion on the supraorbital rim is a strong ligament, which he named the orbital ligament. He also described a narrow band of fusion between the superficial and deep temporal fasciae, which he named the orbicularis temporal ligament. Moss et al. Divided the ligamentous attachments of the temporal area into septa, ligamentous adhesions, and areas of thickening around the orbital rim, which they referred to as thickenings of the periorbital septum. They also divided the temporal fusion line and zone of adhesion described by Nyes into a superior septum, superior temporal septum, and a caudal adhesion, temporal ligamentous adhesion. Although the temporal ligament described by Moss et al. Is synonymous with Nyes' orbital ligament, they each had a slightly different location. The temporal ligament, or temporal ligamentous adhesion, was described as a 15 by 20 mm area of adhesion located 10 mm cephalad to the orbital rim, while the orbital ligament was described as a ligament located on the orbital rim. Moss et al. Described the temporal ligament as the keystone area for its communication with three ligaments. The superior temporal septum superiorly. The inferior temporal septum laterally, and the supraorbital ligamentous adhesion medially. The inferior temporal septum is roughly similar in location to what was described by Nyes as the orbicularis temporal ligament. Similarly, the presence of ligaments in the forehead area is controversial. Some authors considered the forehead devoid of named ligaments and instead as being stabilized by the supraorbital and supratrochlear neurovascular bundles, which act as retaining ligaments. Moss et al. Considered the supraorbital ligamentous adhesion to be the same area that Nyes described as zone B of the forehead, the lower 2 cm of the forehead, where the deepest layer of the deep galea is adherent to the periosteum and where periosteal elevation is particularly difficult. Retaining ligaments of the periorbital area.